Hey guys, it's your girl Charlene. Today's look is going to be a very simple smoky eye, and we're going to get right into it. So first off, we're going to go and prime our eyes with our eyeshadow primer. The eyeshadow primer I'm using is by Urban Decay. I don't want the smoky eye to be extremely intense. I kind of want it to be subtle, so I'm not going to go in with the black primer. I'm just going to go in with the regular primer. As you can see, I already did my brows off camera, and I also already primed my face as well. So I'm going to go in with my BH Cosmetics palette 120, and I'm going to go in with this brown as my transition color and put it all over my lid, like my whole eye. Sorry guys. And I'm just going to blend it in with a big fluffy brush all over my eyelids and all that great stuff. And yeah. Just my buddy. And then I'm going to go in with my eyeshadow by MAC in the shade Embark. And I'm going to put that in my crease. I'm just going to blend that in with a smaller fluffy brush. And yeah, guys. After that, I'm going to go back in with my bigger fluffy brush and blend it out some more because I really want it to be seamlessly. And I'm in love with this brush. I just got it recently from BH, and honestly, it's so amazing, and it's totally inexpensive, guys. So I'm telling you guys, BH is the way to go. I'm then gonna go in with my Naked Cosmetics loose eyeshadow powder. I don't know the name right now, but I will provide it in the description below. And I'm just gonna pack it onto my lid only. But after that, I'm gonna blend it out some more and pack it on again one more time. And yeah. Then after that, we're going to go in with our mascara from Estée Lauder. I'm just going to apply it to my top and bottom lashes. And then I'm going to go in with my Duo Bomb Bomb glue and apply my falsies. My falsies are from Ardell. They're the 120 naturals. I'm in love with naturals. That is what I wear every day. I love naturals. If they're not those, then they're the Demi Wispies by Ardell. And yeah, I'm totally for natural lashes because I just think they look better on my eyes. I feel like sometimes when I wear dramatic lashes, because my eyes are big, they don't look as nice. I don't know, I like that very wispy, fluttery look. I just think it's so bomb on me. Now that we're done the eyes, we're gonna go in with the face. So first off, I'm gonna go to start off and color correct with my LA Pro Girl Orange Corrector. Very inexpensive as well. You get it for like $3.99. I'm just gonna put it on places that are really like dark around my face where I have hyperpigmentation. Then I'm gonna go in with my beauty blender and I'm gonna go and blend that bad boy out. Blend so that I can use less product, because that's the point of correcting, so that you use less product and like you don't see it when you're applying your foundation. Then I'm gonna go in with my MAC mix fluid or something. I'm gonna put it also in the description box, and I'm gonna go in with my flat top brush and blend that all over my face and get myself looking poppin'. Yes guys, poppin'. Only one thing comes to my mind. After applying foundation all over the face, we're gonna go now in highlight. I'm gonna be using LA Pro Girls concealers in the shades Toffee and Fawn to highlight today. Then after that, of course, I'm gonna go in with my beauty blender and start to blend that away and look seamlessly. Woot. Oh, I'm then gonna go in with my black opal powder in the shade light medium, I think that's what the shade's called. I'm just gonna go and set my concealer. This powder is a little too light. The one that I originally used is unfortunately done, so I have to reside with this. But honestly, when I do this, I really do not keep it on. I don't let it to bake because I don't want to look ashy or too gray. So I just leave it on for literally 2 to 3 minutes. And then honestly, I just wipe it off really quick and it just looks nice after. Then we're going to go in and contour with my black opal foundation stick. The shade, I don't know, will also be in the description box. I'm so sorry, guys. Going to go in with my angled brush and I'm going to blend that in. And yeah. Then, of course, when I'm done contouring, I'm going to go in with a bigger brush and start to dust away the powder, all excess powder that I not need on my face. And I'm just going to wipe it off. As you can see, I'm really, like, in that, just wiping it off because I just don't want too much of it. And then I'm, of course, going to go underneath where my contour was to make it more precise or to pop out more and just put a little bit powder there. Literally just let it sit for at least a minute or a few seconds. I didn't even keep it on for that long. And then just dust it off. I don't want it to be too pigmented or whatnot. And yeah, I'm just gonna dust it off right about now, I think. I'm then gonna go in with my Mineral Skin Finish by MAC and apply that all over my face, even on the highlighted areas, because I don't want it to be super intense, my highlight and my contour. Like, I'll go back and add more, you guys will see later on the video, but I'm just gonna put that over my face so that my face can settle properly and just look amazing. Like, everyone has their own routine of how they do their little thing. This is mine. I just like doing it like that because I don't like my highlight to be super prominent and super intense. Like, no, I like it to be subtle, and that just honestly helps it to like go down a bit. I'm then gonna set my contour with MAC's Embark, and I'm just gonna put that where my cheekbone is, and I'm gonna blend in an upwards motion. Yeah, my original contour powder is done, but you can always use a shadow, and honestly, I'm a big fan of Embark. It looks really nice on darker complexion females. It just looks like bomb, and it's not too harsh. And even if my contour is a little too harsh, I always like to go back with my all over powder and just, like, you know, to settle it down so it's not like too harsh, because I don't want to look like a clown. And then I'm gonna go in with MAC's Studio Fix powder and NC55 and just put that underneath my eye because I want to be a little yellow. Why? I don't know. I just like to look yellow, guys. I'm just gonna put it there, and after that I'm gonna wipe it off with another with a big fluffy brush once again, because just that I don't want to, like, I'm scared that when I oxidize I end up looking like weird or gray. So I feel like just doing that makes it like way better. Well, at least to me. So yeah. Yay! I'm then gonna go in with these two blushes by MAC, Raisin and Ambering Rose. I like to mix them both because they look so bomb. Ambering Rose has like a little glow to it, like little crystals, like golden crystals, and then Raisin is like a matte tone. I don't know, together it just looks so amazing, guys. Like, it's just like, it's like a highlighter and a blush all combined. It's like, I love it. It's like amazing. Ambering Rose and Raisin together, like, I can't explain how, like, bomb it looks. Like, look at that. Oh, that flush of color. I'm just having life again to my face. But yeah. And of course, how could I not forget highlighting? So I'm going with MAC's Gold Deposit. This is like amazing. I love this highlighter. Just look at that. Oh, you see that, girl? You better glow, hunty. Glow, mom. Yes. Oh, yes. I love highlighters. Like, I love to glow. Like, I want the aliens from outer space to see me and be like, who is that? Yeah, guys, that's how I'm trying to be. And I'm going to go in with a second highlighter, also by MAC. I don't remember the name, but I will also put it in the description box. This is, like, discontinued, so you will not find it anywhere, so I'm pretty bummed out about it. But it's, like, amazing as well. It's more of a, like, pearly type of tone, and, like, Gold Deposit is gold, so, like, I don't know. I like them together. Together just makes me just, like, look extra glowing, and like I said, I want everybody outer space to see me, from Mars to Jupiter to Pluto. Oh, I'm so extra. Do you guys see my makeup faces? But yeah, guys. Then of course we're gonna go on with the lip. I'm so sad, it's my favorite lip liner by MAC, one of my favorites. This is Plum. I love it so much. It's like amazing. I love it. It's like thebomb.com. But yeah, I'm just gonna go and outline my lips, and I'm gonna overdraw my lips just a little bit, just a smidge, not too much, see, just a little bit, so they look extra plump than they already are. I know I'm extra, they're already big, but I like my lips to be extra juicy, extra big, extra, because I'm extra. And then I'm going to go in with this lip gloss by NYX. Again, the name will be in the description box. I'm so sorry, guys. I'm so terrible this time with my video. I just don't remember. But it's a nice pinky tone, kind of spring look, whatever, spring color. Whatever, guys. It's pink. I love pink. It's popping. My lip gloss is popping like little mama said. And I'm about to be popping in this video. I mean, I already am popping, but y'all already know. As I was recording, I forgot. I'm going to go in with my MAC Smuggler pencil, whatever it's called, for my waterline. I forgot to do that when I was doing my eyes. I noticed when I was, like, recording, I'm like, my eyes look so bare. I'm missing something. I'm like, yeah, my waterline is just so empty. Then I'm going to go in with my Naked Cosmetics eyeshadow that I used before my lid, and really intensify that my waterline and just pack it on. Then after that, I'm gonna go in with my big fluffy brush once again and just blend it out some more. And yeah, guys. Then last but not least, I'm going to go in with my Fix Plus and set my makeup. Thank you for watching, guys. You guys are amazing. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Love you, and bye.